You don't need a lot of magnetic field to produce that effect. I mean, the fact that you have is a minimum magnetic field, and really the limit is very low. Really, the Bolbeck spin effect will have its effect, effect, and also, which is finally a kind of disease due to some anisotropic family, that with this effect, really, you don't measure the magnetic field. What you measure is the direction of the magnetic field, and with the 90 degrees ascertained. Because, well, in fact, you may have perpendicular parallel to the magnetic field. So, really, the measurement of the magnetic field from SI images seems to be very uncertain. Unless we're still in the other ones.
Now, the linear polarization is going just to give you the direction, the direction of the magnetic field. You cannot get the strength of the magnetic field from linear polarization. To get the strength of the magnetic field, you have to detect linear circular polarization.
And then what do you do to measure? I mean, which is the mechanism that you have to assume for estimating magnetic field in that case? Because the circular polarization can be produced from the linear one by rotation, and also by rotation of the field, but not of the field, sorry, of the photon polarization. But at the same time, it can be produced by the standard Maser theory. So, in the case of the circular polarization within SI images, what kind of mechanism are you showing?
I have to think about that.
So there were two people I cut off during the talks, Noam and Martin, Fuerte Espinosa. Yeah, Noam, you had a question for Guillermo.
Yes.
Yeah.
So you want to hear me? It is interesting. You have been working with people who do massive stars. They are looking. So I think these people are way behind us, because they still think that they will get fast rotations in gamma ray bursts from single stars. So, tell us, if you talk with them about massive single star, what? Because I think this is subject related to us, or massive star and so on, but I think they don't think about binary.
You mean if rotation can do bipolarity in massive star?
Well, you look at these people, and then they do some complicated things, that the star expands, and the angle of loose angular momentum, and transfer angular momentum, convection. Usually I lost them somewhere in the middle of the paper, so I just check if they cite my papers and go on.
There is for example, in the range from 10, 12, 15 solar masses, those star goes to the glue loop. In those loops, you transport a lot of angular momentum, in those cases, from the core to the envelope, and there you get bipolar. And there is a nice survey one can do with a phase, because the phase are in that point, I mean the Google is right. And you can find maybe bipolar shapes around the phase.
Well, this is why I say I think they are way behind us. They must have been in 87A, did a blue loop. Everybody asked, they were 87A, the giant public solo.
But about much more massive stars like Etekarai
and... Well, then we know it's binary. Nobody questions it anymore.
One more connection I wanted to make. Was Andres Niedzielski. We talked about low mass companions to bright giants, and something I showed but didn't really go into in any detail in my introductory talk was the beautiful direct imaging of the four planet system orbiting HR 8799. I think I mentioned it, but I didn't mention the fact that those planets are estimated to be of order 5, perhaps 10 Jupiter masses. So you're storing a lot of angular momentum. These are planets that orbital separations of 20 to 80 astronomical units, I believe. So is that sufficient to ramp things up to the extent that you need them ramped up?
No, they are very far away. If you want to to get the angular momentum from those kind of Jupiters, then Jupiters and Jupiter, you really need to eat it, to digest it, to transport all the angular momentum to the Jupiter. As one saw here, hard pass, did the pass, I see, right? If you want to go to 10, 15, or I don't know, 10, 20, as long as you need a binary, if you want to speed up it by tiling.
But can you roll out the closed part?
Sorry?
Forward image, but can you roll out the closed planets?
Can you roll out the closer planets? No, you certainly can't. And in fact, there's evidence that there are two inner rings in dust spectroscopically. So, and I was just about to add that we're, I think, on the verge of being able to get much, much closer in higher contrast ratios, which will both help the search for massive planets, perhaps ground dwarfs at close separations, and will help us planetary nebula enthusiasts find M-star companions perhaps near 10 to the 3, 10 to the 4 solar luminosity primaries. So we should be keeping our eye on those extreme adaptive optics coronagraphic tools. Other comments? Questions for each other?
This finding of magnetic fields around the GB star is very interesting and encouraging. I remember about 17 years ago, there was a workshop at the Technion on magnetic dynamos. So I was working on AGB and I came to these people who do the dynamo of the sun and have perfect prediction of the past. So I asked them, look, what about dynamo operating in AGB star? So the physics in the sun is that the rotation period of the sun is much shorter than the overall term time of the convection. If you take convection length divided by the convection velocity, you get a time longer than the orbital period of the sun, about a month. In AGB stars, it's opposite. The convection is much shorter than the rotation period. So I asked them, so how does the dynamo work in this? And I asked them, what is the ratio? So the overall time of convection is shorter than rotation. Forget about dynamo. I do not talk to these people. So show you that if you want help for people who do dynamo, you probably will not get it. So just a comment, and I think these are great results.
Are there any other burning questions? If not, let's thank all the speakers from this room. I'm going to pass the mantle of summary speaker onto Orsola, but first there's a piece of business to attend to. And I'm going to have to watch Orsola's talk on Google on the flight home.